Mabuhay! Welcome back to my channel. This is Daryl again. In today's video, I'm gonna teach you some vocabulary related to vegetables or verduras in Espanol. So what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna show you some pictures of our vegetable here, and then later on you have to guess its equivalent term in Spanish. So are you guys ready? Are you ready? Estáis listos? Oh my god, girl, it's been a while. So if you're new to this channel, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. We do videos related to Spanish, English, and related to languages mostly. And I'm really passionate about teaching. So let's just get right into the video, girl. So I have here some examples of the vegetables that we commonly have the same words in Filipino. So, sa Filipino, kalimitan meron tayong mga words na ganito. However, they are just spelled differently. So, titingnan natin kung mahuhulaan nyo ba kung ano ang mga gulay na ito, di ba? Gulay. Gulay na ito sa Espanyol. So, this is the first one. Primero, what is that? ¿Qué es esto? En español, we call it papa. Papa. Okay? Not papa. Papa means father. So, we have to pronounce this as papa. Papa. Or patata. Muy bien. Next one, we have... ¿Qué es eso? Cebolla. Cebolla. Sa Filipino, tinatawag nating sibuyas. Muy bien. So kung mapapansin nyo, karamihan talaga, the same lang. Nag-iiba lang yung spelling niya at saka yung pagbigkas. However, marirecognize natin na yung sibuyas pala galing sa cebolla sa Espanyol. Muy bien. Next, we have... ¿Qué es eso? Tomate. Muy bien. Tomate. Okay. Tomate. Actually, kung mapapansin nyo, mas malapit siya sa English kasi sa English na tawag natin siya na tomato or tomato. Depende kung saan English-speaking country ka, di ba? However, in the Philippines, we just call it kamatis, di ba? It's quite different, but yeah, it has some similarities. Pero in that case, mas close siya sa English, tomate. Next, we have... Pepino, girl. Mahilig ba kayo sa pepino? Diba? Ako gusto ko yung pepino lalo na pag may mga pritong pagkain. So, whenever I have fried food with me, I always want pepino, tomate, okay? Cebolla. So, pinag-mix ko sila normally. So, masarap siya. So, yun. Nagutom na tuloy ako. At ang next naman natin na nagulay ay... Zanahoria. Repeat. Zanahoria. 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 So, zanahoria is just carrot. Sa Filipino, ano ba ang Tagalog ng carrots? Parang sinasabi natin carrots lang, di ba? O bumili ka nga ng isang kilong carrots doon. Di ba? So, parang ang hirap minsan kasi may mga words na parang inadapt na natin siya sa English na mas ginagamit natin siya kaysa doon sa Filipino word, which is sad. Kasi hindi natin alam. Pero, yun, carrots. Ang next naman ay... Apio. Okay, apio. So, yung apio ay celery. O, ano ang Tagalog ng celery? Sige nga. Sino ang makakapagsabi sa akin? Anong Tagalog ng celery? Ako rin, hindi ko rin alam. So, yun, celery. By the way, guys, some people say that tomato is a fruit or tomato is a fruit. So, bahala na sila ang mag-decide kung ano ba talaga ang tomato or tomato. I'm not a scientist to decide on that. Pero, there are research studies that show that tomato is a fruit and not a vegetable. But here in my list, since, I mean, I just I just use this list of vegetables that I have now. So, might as well banggitin na din. So, ayun. So, next naman natin ay... This is so close to our language. Maíz. Maíz. Okay? So, in Espanol, maíz. 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 Es lo mismo. It's the same. So, very close. Ang next naman natin ay... Cauliflower. Cauliflower is cauliflower. Cauliflower. Okay? Cauliflower. Cauliflower. Muy bien. It's quite close to English actually than in Filipino. Because I think in Filipino, we use the same word. Kasi, ano ba yung Tagalog ng cauliflower? Parang wala, no? Ang hirap. Next one, we have broccoli. 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 It's the same in Filipino. We just use the word broccoli. Muy bien! And now, we have lechuga. Lettuce. Lechuga. And the next one, siguiente, tenemos calabaza. Calabaza. Okay? Sa Filipino, ginagamit lang natin yung K, di ba? Tapos yung S. So, calabaza. So, hindi naman siya ganoon ka hira. So, yun siya. Meron tayong kalabasa. Kalabasa. So, the same. At, eto favorite ko to. Kapag nagluluto ako with eggs, normally, fina-fry ko siya. Ano kaya to? Sinasama ko siya doon sa pag-prito. Talong. Berenjena. Say it again with me. Repeat it. Berenjena. Berenjena. Muy bien, muy bien. La taste bien, eh? Berenjena. And the last one is... Calabacín. Say, calabacín. Calabacín. So, zucchini. So, actually, dito sa Spain, tsaka ko lang siya na-appreciate. Kasi sa Philippines, parang hindi naman siya masyadong common, di ba? Na merong calabacín. Well, since ako, in my case, hindi naman common sa family ko nung makain ng kalabacin or zucchini every time. So, it's quite new for me. So, I hope you guys learn some vocabularies related to vegetables today. I am really happy that you are able to do that. You recognize all these vegetables. So, I would like to encourage you to eat more vegetables, fruits, because we're experiencing pandemic around the world. So, we have to keep our immune system strong. And one of the ways to do that is by eating veggies. So, thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, please do share and like and subscribe to my channel. I do a lot of things related to culture and languages. So, if you're up to that, then just follow me. Thank you so much, guys, and I'm gonna see you soon. Ciao!